The day before Thanksgiving is usually the busiest travel day of the year. Not this year. The ongoing pandemic may have you wondering what air travel looks like right now. Fox 23's Rick Marinon booked a flight on two different airlines to show you what it's like flying during a pandemic in this Fox 23 investigation.
I've grown up around airplanes all of my life, and when you have parents who work in the military and on the commercial side, it kind of comes with the territory. But I don't think I've ever seen anything as bad as this. I bought a plane ticket just to see what flying was like right now. On one flight, we took American Airlines from Tulsa to Dallas-Fort Worth International Airport. Then I took a rideshare across town to Dallas Love Field, back home to Tulsa. But I didn't want these airlines to put their best foot forward if I called ahead, and I didn't want them to show us their nicest fancy video. I wanted to see what it was like when they weren't expecting anybody to come except for a regular passenger. So with some GoPros and some cell phones, you're able to see exactly what I saw. Checking in at American Airlines was a bit different. Those self-service kiosks that a lot of people use, they are now offline. And if you're checking a bag, you're going to want to give yourself some of that extra time because those self-service kiosks are now just one long line. You also have to individually testify to the check-in agent that you do not have COVID-19. Now, I didn't have any bags to check in, so there is a separate kiosk that I used, and I signed my COVID waiver, and then I was able to get my boarding pass and go on. Homeland Security doesn't like it when you record them doing their job, so I wasn't able to show you anything as far as my experience going through. For the most part, it is the same, but we got some video at the airport of other passengers going through what I went through. Passengers are actually scanning their own ticket, then they give their ID over, and then a government agent actually asks you to pull your mask down to see if the face on your ID matches your face. But it was packed there at the American gate waiting area. Of course, everyone was masked up, but it's when they announced it was time to board, everyone got up like they usually would before the pandemic, and we were all just crowded in. I actually waited back a little bit because I wanted to see just what a full flight was going to look like. Going down the jet bridge, it was shoulder to shoulder, and it was that way all the way into the plane, and it was so full. But after the doors closed and then they did the announcements, that's when you started to remember you weren't in Kansas anymore, so to speak. The announcement had this clear statement of do not take your mask off.
If you're unwilling to follow this requirement, you may not be allowed to fly with us in the future.
Airlines are not messing around when they warn you to keep your mask on during the flight. At the end of October, Delta announced around 500 people were barred for life because they either refused to wear a mask or they took their mask off sometime during the flight. So the plane parks at the gate in Dallas, and we get off row by row just like usual, and there are signs all over the place, keep your mask on, welcome to Dallas, keep your mask on, please. Southwest is considered one of the best, if not the best, when it comes to how they've responded to COVID. So once again, I got in the terminal and I checked in, but unlike American, Southwest has its kiosks open, and everyone is using them except when you need to drop your bag off. And there really wasn't a lot of social distancing inside the terminal itself. The safety measures for Southwest come when it's time to board. Southwest is the only one that openly brags on its commercials, not just about its cleaning procedures, but also keeping that middle seat open. And it's during the boarding time is when you actually started to see where the difference was. If you remember that mob of people we saw at American, that's not what was happening at Love. Southwest does group boarding, and usually they do 30 people at a time. This time they're still doing group boarding, but they're doing 10 people at a time, and there are dots on the ground for each of them to stand on. And it's at the gate where they made the announcement of keeping your mask on the entire flight. But once again, once you get down the jet bridge, that's where you start to see people packed in. Here's a picture I took from the row that I had to myself, and you can see just all of the middle seat headrests that were empty, except for one or two where some families wanted to sit together, which was perfectly understandable, and the airline let them do that. I really wanted to fly on Southwest because they promise something that no one else does. They say every 2 to 3 minutes, there is fresh air that is pumped into the cabin. And I wanted to see if I noticed anything. I turned on the air conditioner throughout the flight, and I was expecting this whoosh or a chilly feeling of fresh air being pumped into the plane. But that never happened, and there's a reason why. So when you look at Southwest Airlines' own animation and you look at how a Boeing 737's air conditioner works, you start to realize it's not necessarily something new that they're doing. It's just they're highlighting something that is really cool standard operating procedure that many people have actually never known about. For the most part, the flight was really normal. Not once did I hear the flight attendants even talk about a mask in any of their announcements. It was just expected that one gate announcement was good enough for the entire flight. But it's that open middle seat business model and assuring people that the plane was practically empty is where Southwest reported that they actually needed to change things on the day I was flying. Southwest Corporate announced in their shareholder meeting that they were actually going to be opening up the middle seat on December 1st because they need more people in order to have their flights be more profitable. But the crazy thing is, we spoke with some Southwest passengers once I got off the plane at baggage claim, and they said they were fine with that.
I don't have any qualms about the middle seating. It'll definitely fit more people on the plane. But, you know, some people might not be opposed to it, but I personally don't have any problem because they do a really good job of making sure that everybody's clean and comfortable.
I found one passenger in baggage claim at Tulsa who said he was coming for a wedding and he had already made future plans and that he'd already flown before.
I think it's going to be okay for people. I mean, we're all masked up. I came with my family, so there was three of us could sit together. But if you're not, you know, if you don't have that many in your family, you might have somebody there.
I didn't get to fly on United or Delta, but they do have similar safety features in place. I did take a picture, however, of Delta's seating area. They have every other seat spaced off. They're the only ones enforcing social distancing while in the terminal waiting for the flight to start. What I just showed you can be considered the new normal for a long time. Airlines don't expect to recover until 2022, 23, or 2024 at the earliest. So this is going to take a long time before we can even think about flying the way we used to.
And that was a really interesting look. Thanks, Rick. And if you are wondering if masks on planes really prevent the spread of COVID, you can find more information about a study United Airlines did with the Defense Department inside this story on Fox23.com.